Good day. Today we're going to discuss about how to start a cement block business. But in this part, we are going to discuss why should you start the business today. A few years ago, when I started talking about cement blocks, I had a lot of people being resistant about this idea. People thought that cement blocks can never be introduced in Malawi, because they said that because of the high cost of cement, people are not going to be willing to use cement blocks. I was persistent and I kept on marketing the idea until eventually people embraced the idea. Today, we are seeing that there is a lot of people who have ventured into this industry, including government. Government has banned the use of bent bricks in their projects. And as a result, we have seen that NGOs and corporate companies have also followed. It's just a matter of time before the government is going to ban the use of bent bricks completely. So it is best that you start the business today, because if you do that, you will be an early bird. As we know, an early bird catches the worm. So by the time the government is going to ban the use of bent bricks completely, you should be far ahead. You should have established yourself, you have established your customer base, which will make it very easy for you to run your business. So you should start preparing, doing your research, finding a place where you can start your business. And there are two types of businesses, of which I'm going to discuss in the later videos. But I can just give you an idea. You have a business where you can be making blocks on the customer's premises, or you can be making blocks on your site and delivering them to your customer. I'm going to give you a brief, detailed explanation of this type of business and how to start and run a business. So keep on following this series so that you can learn more. Thank you.